I'm Kathleen Moran, and my official title is Civic Center Superintendent here at our complex, which is the Glenview Mansion, the F. Scott Fitzgerald Theater, and the cottage. And then all the programs that get run out of the office, our garden plots, our rentals of parks for picnics, and rentals at the Pump House and the Elwood Smith Rec Centers. And the list seems to go on and on. We even work with the rooftop in town center, so there's a lot going on here. I love the people, I love the facilities, but what I like the best is that I feel we're serving a lot of people. I have a very community mindset about this. We do about 1,200 events here a year, and we're helping a lot of people. There's at least 90,000, 100,000 people that are here, and that's a lot. You know, whether it's a small retreat for a company that gets to brainstorm here out of their own environment. Maybe it's a memorial reception. Maybe it's a family picnic. I mean, it's just endless what we make happen, but they're people. It's about the people. Success here is not only the bride deciding what she wants in her day, but her caterer making that happen, her DJ. There's a lot of pieces that come together, and that they operate within some of our house rules so that everything comes together.
Your guests should be coming 7:30 or 8, that's good, and then they should be leaving at about midnight so that the caterer has the last hour to clean up. There is no smoking in the house. The urns are on the porches. There are heat and smoke detectors here.
I am Susan Kleiss, and I work at Glenview Mansion. I call myself the mansion administrator. I'm kind of the event planner, bill payer, woman of all trades. The biggest part of my job is working with clients who come into us who want to hold events here at the mansion, showcasing the property, doing tours with these folks, helping them imagine what their event could be like. Having it here at Glenview, it's a great house for a party. Some people need to kind of be helped along. Some people have a vision and have a plan. And that's, we do meetings and weddings and birthday parties, quinceañera, and all kinds of other events. So we're constantly planning parties or functions here. And I think that's one of the things I really like about my job is interacting with the folks who work together with the families and the clients to make these special events happen. We have some caterers and some photographers and DJs as well as florists who are here very frequently. Sometimes when I'm doing a walkthrough with a bride and a caterer, I feel like the caterer should be doing it, and they're just really so comfortable and familiar with the setup and our rules and things, and I think that's what helps people be at ease with their events, and that they are in good hands with people who have done a lot of events here, and they know how to do it, how to make it flow, how to make it work, what the rules are. You know, they just walk in and get going. There's not the anxiety or the question of where's the kitchen. You know, there are people who've been here a lot, and I think that's terrific. Yes, there are some people who I would consider friends. They're just professional people who really put together great events.
How's the wedding business?
It's fine.
You know, lots of couples.
Lots of couples. I was here a couple times, like in the last month or 6 weeks.
Excellent.
Or so.
Excellent.
Yeah, so it's fine. It's fitting. And I have graduate school too. I went back to school last summer, so
great.
I'm like between work and school.
So you're a ministerial degree and a graduate degree.
And
which is more fun, marrying people, right?
Yeah, hands down. and talking about food. Those are my two favorite things.
Yeah. So we've seen a lot of events, and I feel like, you know, learning with the rest of the staff and working with the staff here. Nanette's been invaluable. Our custodial staff is incredible. They are the guys who make it work here. You know, we have the puzzle of how many tables can we fit in there and how many people can we squeeze around to make this meeting fit in the dining room or the conservatory. And I'm going to Gary Brown because he's my puzzle man, you know, and makes it fit. And Wayne Butler and Greg Thomas, great guys who really help a lot and care about the mansion, I think. and help us get these events off the ground.
Last can, something else she says she wanted. Oh, okay. Pins. Do you have any extra pins?
Stealing from my desk.
We are a team, and it just amazes me because it's critical that everybody does their piece. And I think every event gets touched by almost everybody who works here. Success is in the details. Most of what we're doing is a one-time only event, so we've got one chance to get it right for somebody's special wedding or their live performance on the stage or whatever it is that we're supporting them with.
My name's Kim Haug. I'm the theater supervisor, and I run the Fitzgerald Theater. I also help out up here with Kathleen as far as assistant to her as far as the mansion and the rest of the grounds. So I do the booking, the initial inquiry, and do the contracts with them, and then follow up with box office information. What they need as far as their setups, talk to their technical people. We try to have everything as much ready as possible when people come in, so that we charge by the hour, so it makes it to their advantage if they give us some more information. Because it's too late if somebody's coming in on a Saturday and they say they want something that's 220 volt or something, if they're coming from overseas. It's kind of late to try to get it. So as much as possible, we try to get the information ahead of time so there aren't any big surprises. Sometimes people make assumptions and then we have a lot of stuff, but we don't have everything, so. The theater is pretty much booked all right year round, so I think we do in the 150 to 155 events a year. So it's pretty much every Friday, Saturday, Sunday. There are sometimes we do up to 5 events on a weekend. And then we have some events during the week. Mostly the during the week events are rehearsals, Monday through Thursday. We have a lot of different types of events. Most of our groups, our standard groups, are community groups. So we have a little theater group that does straight plays. We have a musical theater group that does big musicals. In there right now is Victorian Lyric Opera Company. It does musicals of the Gilbert and Sullivan era. And then we also have some city groups. The Finest was just in there with their original production.
Okay.
Wonder What's Taking Nelly So Long?
Yes.
Okay.
That's this one.
So Wonder What's Taking Nelly So Long?
It's kind of hard to shoot us when we're in the dark all the time.
My name is Joe Palomera. I'm the theater production specialist here at the F. Scott Fitzgerald Theater for the city of Rockville. Part of my job is to work closely with the city groups and resident companies when they come in do productions in the theater. A lot of it has to do with making sure they have the right set materials coming in, their lighting design, their sound design, helping them out with questions on a particular build. So this last production that was just in was translations from RLT, and they wanted to hang a window. And their method of hanging the window was to use fishing line. Well, and by theater safety standards, fishing line is unacceptable. So you have to use steel rigging cable. And to them, they didn't realize that, you know, that was kind of illegal in the theater business to use fishing line to hang something from a grid 15 feet in the air. So it's a lot of teaching back and forth with these groups. The Finest is a great production, and it's at the same time, it's also a great learning experience for them as well as me, because they're such a young group. They're an award-winning group. The production they're doing, A Change Is Gonna Come, was written by their director, Kashi, and it's an original script. But the best part about it is I get to work with their cast and their tech crew on showing them how things work in the theater that they won't necessarily get from other departments in the city, because a lot of them are in after school activities and stuff like this. But I just did a training session with them on how to run sound equipment. So I feel by working with these kids, I give them something that they can use later on in life.
So if we're doing this, we get real fancy here. And I was back in my old job.
on the road with some folks?
Yeah, I did. I've been on the road with Dog Eat Dog, Child's Play, Kix, Wrathchild. I do a lot of local stuff too at the Verizon Center and Baltimore Arena, so I've worked for everybody. Most recently, I did a show with Ozzy Osbourne up at First Mariner Arena. I did Carrie Underwood, TSO.
I actually helped design the sound system at the Plaza stage and the lighting system down there. And they had their summer concert series, which our techs run for special events. So I go down there every season with a couple techs. We set up the sound system, we set up the lighting system, we test it, I train the guys to run it. Every Thursday night for the summer series, they're down there providing sound and support for special events for those concerts. We also do hometown holidays. So there's usually seven stages for hometown holidays. So me and my crew run all seven stages. Special events books the entertainment for those stages. Some of the stages we go out to bid for sound on. And even though there's a sound company assigned to that stage, or three stages maybe, I still have one or two of my guys assisting on those stages. The biggest part about this job is every day there's something in the theater and every day is a new challenge. You know, you have your staples with the, like the concert band and the chorus, where you just need a piano and some chairs, maybe some shelves. But when you get into production work, every production is different, every production is unique, and every production demands something different.